So it is holiday season. I'm sure most of you already planned your family getaways and eager to hit the road. And this morning we're joined by Nikki Bush, our parenting expert, to give us some great advice on how to keep the kids occupied and try to avoid that frequently asked question, are we there yet? Nikki, nice to have you back in studio.
Thanks, Ewan.
So it's an important time of the year for the families to get away, spend a bit of time, but you need to get to your end destination, and that's where the trick comes in.
Absolutely. So it's keeping your kids happy on the run, okay. Whether it's a one-hour jaunt around the mountain or whatever to get to the beach, or yeah. Whether it's a 13-hour trip, say, from Joburg yeah. down to Cape Town for the school holidays. You need to keep sanity in the family. And so, you know, kids get bored.
They get bored easily.
There are certain things that send kids ballistic. One, they're thirsty. Another one, they're hungry. Yeah. Another one, they're tired, and often they don't know how to tell you about those things. But the biggie, of course, when you're traveling is, I'm bored, and when are we going to get there?
Exactly. So let's start off at the beginning, because you're going to start off in the car, leaving home, on the way. The first initial excitement is going to wear off initially, because you're bored, exactly. So how do you take care of that?
Well, I think technology has taken care of some of it for us, because many families have DVD players in their car. So if you're on a 6 or a 12-hour journey, you can probably while away a few hours behind a DVD. Personally, for me, I find that this is quality time with my children. Yeah. And I prefer not to use too much technology. It's a great time when we can, say, perhaps play word games with older children. They're completely free. So if I say blue, what do you say?
Red.
And then I say strawberry, and then you say?
There we go. And
so
fruit.
We keep doing these associations. How about building the alphabet as we go along? There's so much visual clutter out there. Lots of signage, trucks, etc. Go from A to Z.
All right.
Then, of course, you've got, tablets and things that belong to you maybe, but the kids might want to be using.
Yeah.
And we've got this fabulous little activity case that you put your device in. And for the littlies, while we're on the littlies, fascination is an amazing thing. This little ball, it's just a little peekaboo ball, and these things pop out, and I promise you, even 3, 4, and 5-year-olds will grab their baby's sister or brother's toy. They want to know how this happens. So they spend ages. I've had children fighting over that in the car.
That is fascinating.
And also for the littlies, this is a little discovery house.
Oh,
it
wow.
is electronic. And so you press the buttons, things happen, the doorbell.
Yeah.
Day, night. So teaching children vocabulary, eye-hand coordination, fine motor control, etc.
Oh, right. So you were joking when you said technology really plays a big role.
It does, absolutely. And then we've got also baby. This is for the under twos. So a little laptop on its own teaches shape, colour. Oh, I think I've switched off. Music, shape, colour, quantity, etc. Nice and light. And small. So I'm going for things that are well packaged.
Exactly. That's the one I want to ask you, because you need to, you know, kind of think about the toys you're taking with, because it's essentially in the car.
Yes, or in the airplane.
Or
trains and buses. So it's got to be small. So you'll see most things I've got here are quite small. Here we go. This is a little all-night dress the princess.
Yeah.
It's magnetic. Look at all these magnetic clothes. It's got two seams, one on the back and one on the front of the box, so the little girls can dress their little princesses.
I like it.
These are this is the brain game called Noah's Ark, and it's got all these little animals, and it's got 48 different problems that you have to solve. The problems are all here, and you have to position the animals so that they solve the problem.
That's
fantastic. Also small, can fit in your handbag. Holiday doodle cards.
Nice.
So here we've got a whiteboard marker, and we've got about 80 cards, and they all have different instructions, and the children have to draw in missing parts of the picture.
All right.
So draw butterflies flying around the flower.
So let's not try, draw on Dad's car seat at all.
Absolutely. Put a big sun hat on the dog's head. When you're going to a restaurant, you might have a few, like 20 minutes or 30 minutes to wait for the food to arrive. This is called Jawbones. It's a little construction toy set. So why not take along something small that'll keep the kids busy for ages? So pushing things together, fine motor control, strengthening the fingers and the hands, as well as the imagination. Then for older children and even adults, this is called IQ Fit. And it, once again, comes with loads and loads of problems. And you've got to position all these pieces back in the right place. And here are all the different problems.
But ultimately, it's all about the parents interacting with the kids on a journey, right?
100%. Children play up and misbehave when they are not getting the right kind of attention.
Yeah.
That's the bottom line, is if they know that you're otherwise occupied and that you're not paying any attention, they'll do anything to get your attention. So every now and again, especially if you have children under about the age of 3, climb in the back seat, one of you, while the other one's driving, climb in the back seat, be with the kids for 15, 20 minutes. Yeah. You'll be amazed at how they can get through the next hour or two if you've just interacted with them.
And your journey will just be so much quicker.
So much better.
Great stuff. Thank you so much, Nikki. Of course, you can log into our website, expressoshow.com, for some great ideas from Nikki as to what toys you can take in the car.